And those who are neither Brahmi, they have no brain to become Brahmi, not to become Kshatriya or Vaishya, they are called Shudras. And a Shudra's business is to serve the other upper three classes, laborer, worker classes, and satisfied with some service. So here it is said that Tata Parikshit Dvijavarga Shikshaya. He was educated and trained up by the best class of the Brahmins, not by the Shudras. Shudras training, what he can become? He can become a rascal, that's all. The training was entrusted to the first class Brahmin, who is himself trained up to speak truth, satya samadama, to remain clean, to become very simple in habit, to become master of knowledge and practically application. Such persons should be the trainer, should be the teacher. Not a third-class rascal becomes a teacher and professor. He has no idea how to speak truth. He is speaking all lies, theories, and getting Nobel Prize. Such a Shudra is honored at the present moment. You see, who has no knowledge. So many so-called philosophers and scientists simply speaking lies and untruth. They have no knowledge. As soon as you challenge them, they will say, yes, we are trying. In future we shall do it. But if you are trying, then where is your knowledge? Why you are taking the post of a teacher? You are a cheater. You have no full knowledge and still you are putting some theory to mislead the people. For example, just like they are putting out this theory that from matter life has come. All right, life has come from matter. Just prove it. Take matter, whatever materials you want, take and produce a life. That we shall see in future. Then why are you talking this nonsense? Science means observation and experiment. There must be experiment also. But without experiment, they are putting on this theory and getting Nobel Prize. Although it is not a fact. We are followers of Vedic principles, we know that matter or life, everything comes from life, not from matter. We know it certain. How do you know? Krishna says, matta sarvam pravartati. Everything comes from me, and Krishna is the supreme life. So we have no difficulty. Because we know matta sarvam pravartati. Sarvam means matter and life, both. Everything. There are two things, matter and life. There is no third thing. So, Krishna says, aham sarvasya prabhava. I am the original source of everything. Everything means matter and there are two things. Matter and life. That is not very difficult to understand. So, sarvang, aham sarvasya prabhava, matta sarvang pravartate, iti matya bhajanti imam, buddha bhava samanita. Iti matya. When one understands this, that Krishna is the source of both matter and life. So devotees are not rascals. They are in full knowledge. Iti matta. When they are confident that Krishna is the source of everything. Iti matta. Bhajante ma. They become my devotee. Iti matya bhajante ma buddha. Buddha means highly elevated in knowledge, Buddha. Just like Lord Buddha, elevated knowledge. So Buddha. So how this knowledge can be gotten? Unless one is trained by Dvijavarga Shiksha, first class learned Brahmin. One has to learn from him, not from the rascals, fools, cats and dogs. No. That is not learning. deserves a siksha. So Parikshit Maharaj, his first qualification is not only Parikshit Maharaj, but all the kings during the monarchy. Monarchy does not mean because he is a son of king, therefore he should be king. No. He should be fully trained up by the Dijavarja, by the best class of Brahmins. That is monarchy. So Parikshit Maharaj, tata. Tata means thereafter. After his father, Pancha Pandav, his father and uncles retired and left kingdom, entrusting everything to the grandchild, because their sons all died in the battle of Kurukshetra. Parikshit Maharaj only, he was saved because he was a posthumous child. After the death of his father in the battlefield of Kurukshetra, he was in the womb of his mother, he took birth. And his grandfather took care of him. This is Parikshit Maharaj's life. He did not see his father from birth. So this grandfather, so grandfathers, they retired, entrusted, the whole kingdom was entrusted to the grandchild, Maharaj Parikshit. He was trained up by the first class Brahmin. Tatap Parikshit Dijavarja Sikshaya. Mahin Mahabhagavato Sasasaha. Mahin, Mahin means its earthly planet. Up to Maharaj Parikshit, 5,000 years ago, the whole world was being ruled over by one king, one emperor. There are no so many nations, or no so many presidents, or no. Simply one king. Mahin, this word, Mahin means the earthly planet. This is the history. From Mahabharat, we understand that the whole world was under one flag. This Pandavas. Now United Nations means 3,000 flags. 3,000 nations. So that is not democracy, or that is not good ruling. The best ruling is monarchy, and monarch means he must be a perfectly trained person by the best Brahmins. That is perfect government. Not that this democracy, some rascals and fools, they are voting another rascal and fool, and by hook and crook he comes to the post, he does not like to give it up and makes things very miserable. This kind of government, now your Senate is proposing, let us pray to God how we can get good government. They're coming down to again. But why not train? Now you are going to pray to God, please give us good government. Why don't you elect a person, Mahabhagavata? Mahabhagavata. That is Krishna consciousness movement. That people, you become devotees. Bhagavata. And you select one Mahabhagavata to be your ruler. Then you'll be happy. Not only Bhagavata, not of your caliber, but still further. There are Bhagavata, there are three kinds of devotees. three kinds of devotees means neophyte, middle class, and Mahabhagavata means one who can see God in everything and everything in God. That is Mahabhagavata. That is explained in Bhagavad Gita. Sarva bhuteshu japasya atma. He does not see anything except God. Everything in God and God in everything. That is the qualification Mahabhagavata. So just see how elevated was Maharaj Parikshit, that he was Mahabhagavata.